The State Minister for Higher Education officiated at the release of the end-of-program examination results for April and May series, which were conducted by the Uganda Business and Technical Examinations Board, UBTEB, between 21st April and 26th May 2023. Out of the 262 accredited examination centers, 13,209 candidates registered for examinations, 8,538 turned up for the examinations, and only 6,913 candidates successfully passed, representing 81%.
We are releasing, this is where exams conducted to level out the effects of COVID-19. It's like we are removing a certain cohort, because you see, when they staggered the opening of institutions, we had so many students. Sometimes you'd find like in year two, you have three cohorts. So that's what we are removing. But the current exams, we are doing almost 70,000 students. Actually, the numbers are growing. What is lacking now, the institution to absorb the students. Even both public and private, we can't take all the students.
Minister Muyingo was impressed by the increased number of female students enrolling for technical studies and completion. 3,931 female candidates successfully completed the program against 2,982 male candidates.
We are grateful for the continued increase in enrollment of trainees for TVET programs, especially the 7,701 female graduates. Out of a total of 13,209 trainees that have acquired the competences in the various trades. This is a tremendous achievement to the TVET subsector. This will supplement the ongoing efforts to reduce youth unemployment.
However, the minister condemned cases of examination malpractice, which were reported in these exams, and endorsed the board's recommendation to cancel examination results of the entire semester for affected candidates in accordance with the law.
Very ashamed. I don't want to hear this again. I wish I can have a solution. It's embarrassing. Whenever we come here, we talk about all these things. I'm happy the students are in attendance today. I therefore agree with the recommendation of the board that the results of the affected candidates be cancelled.
Muyingo urged the board to take a firm stand on examination malpractice by revoking center numbers from institutes where malpractice was recorded.
That we found out that the principal of the institution contributed, their center will be withdrawn. We need to stop this vice, otherwise we are continuously being embarrassed.
Onesmus Oyesigire, the executive secretary of UBTEB, noted that despite measures put in place to curb the vice, candidates still hire impersonators to sit exams on their behalf, and many have been arrested in due course.
Oh yes, we have impersonation. Impersonation sometimes comes in, but we have gotten them most of the time. You get them. Of course, that's a criminal offense. They are taken on by police. Sometimes they end up in courts of law, but that one also comes. Somebody hires a brother who is at the university to come and sit mathematics. But once we get you, and we get them.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.